Hey everyone, hope you're doing well. This video I want to give you my thoughts on the 2016 MacBook Pro. In my 2016 MacBook Pro, I mean the one that Apple released in October, or I guess unveiled in October. Now personally, I didn't buy this laptop, but I still want to give my opinion on the controversy that surrounds it. Now before we get into that, I'm going to go over some of the things that I think are really good. First, it's thinner, it's lighter, it's smaller overall. The build quality is, I'm sure, top of the line. Apple laptops and desktops and just their products in general have always been a really high quality. They look great, arguably the best looking laptops on the market. Now, I consider myself a pretty open-minded person, but I think the Windows laptop side, there's just a few laptops that can even come close to the build quality and the overall aesthetics of the MacBook Pro. So aside from the awesome build quality, it also has a better looking display. It can display more colors. And on the inside, pretty much every hardware component is faster than the previous model. Now, in my eyes, there's three main controversies with the MacBook Pro. First, the keyboard, the trackpad, and also the ports. So let's go ahead and talk about the trackpad first. Now, Apple said that the trackpad is, I don't know how much bigger, but it's huge. I've tried it out in a store and it's really big. I can almost fit my whole hand on the trackpad. The problem that I see with that and that I kind of experience with my MacBook, which also has a pretty big trackpad, is that when you're moving the cursor around and you try to click, if you're clicking with your left hand on the left side, so like a normal left click, but you have your palm rest on the right side, and you also have the right click enabled in settings. So sometimes what I experience is that when I try to click, left click, it picks up that it's also sensing my right hand on the right side, and it thinks that it's a right click. So of course that's gonna be pretty annoying. Now Apple does have pretty good palm rejection, but it's not perfect. Of course, no palm rejection is perfect. So if you have your palm sitting just slightly on the trackpad, it's not going to think of it as a palm. It's going to think of it as just another finger. It's a small touch on the trackpad, so it's thinking it's a finger. And when you click down, there's, of course, no actual buttons, so when it clicks the whole trackpad, and it thinks that your right hand sitting a little bit on the trackpad is meaning that you want to right click. So that can be pretty annoying. I can definitely see both sides of the argument here. A lot of people want a bigger trackpad. It's nice to have a big trackpad, but then that does come with a little bit of a drawback. Overall, I think the trackpad is something that people are going to have to get used to. There's really no way around it. Now moving on to the keyboard. Apple introduced the butterfly switches back in the original MacBook. I have the second generation MacBook behind me, and in my experience, the typing experience, it's a little weird. It's hard to get used to at first. The keys are shallow, and sometimes because of that, it's hard to know whether I'm actually pressing a button or pressing the aluminum in between the buttons. And once I got used to it, it wasn't that bad. Now the new MacBook Pros have the second generation of these butterfly switches, and I've tried them out in store and they're a lot better. It feels like there's about twice as much key travel. They're really clicky, it's kind of loud. Just like the first generation, I think people are just gonna have to get used to the butterfly switches because it is different than just the regular scissor switches. Once that happens though, once they get used to all that, I think it's gonna be a really nice keyboard. I think people are gonna enjoy it. People are gonna type really fast. People might not like the loudness of it. It is really clicky, but in the end, I think people are gonna enjoy it. Now, probably the main thing about the MacBook Pro, and honestly what made me not buy it, I actually was going to purchase the new MacBook Pro. I was planning on it. I've been saving up for a few months, and that is the USB-C ports. So the 13-inch MacBook Pro has two USB-C ports and a 3.5mm headphone jack, and the 15-inch model has four USB-C ports and a 3.5mm headphone jack. Now, this isn't the first time that Apple's taken away something that's just a standard throughout the entire world, really. In the past, they've taken away things like the floppy disk. That's why you don't see those around. And of course, now they're taking away the 3.5mm headphone jack from the iPhone, which some people are, of course, going to be annoyed by that, but that's a completely different story. For the MacBook Pros, these USB-C ports, from a technology standpoint, they're really advanced. I think they get, 40 gigabits per second transfer rate. And as of right now, there's really no hard drive or solid state drive or any kind of hardware component that can really take advantage of all that bandwidth. These USB-C ports can also be used with pretty much any kind of device. You can plug in, of course, dongles to output HDMI, more USB. The possibilities are really endless with these USB-C ports, which makes them future-proof. But having only USB-C ports is, I think, where Apple could have done differently. I believe in maybe 1 to 2, as late as 3 years from now, almost everything is going to be USB-C. So you're not going to need a dongle in the future, but as of right now, it's kind of tough. It's a hard transition to make, and especially how Apple did it, where it's just completely out with the old and completely in with the new. That's tough to do. It's really hard on the consumer. They're going to have to buy dongles. They're going to have to upgrade drives that are USB-C. But in a couple years from now, that's not going to be a problem. Now, I don't believe in critiquing something or someone or a company without offering a solution. And this is my solution. I think what Apple should have done is kept about 3 different ports, maybe 4. First, MagSafe. I think even though all the USB-C ports are able to charge the laptop, which is pretty cool, MagSafe was a huge deal. It's a key feature in the MacBooks that they used to have. So if you're somehow not familiar with what MagSafe is, basically the connector to charge your computer magnetically just snaps onto the side of your computer and it's good to go. It's going to charge. The key to that is that if you were to trip over your power cable or something like that, it's not going to completely yank the laptop off your desk. Just the magnetic connection is just going to fall out just like any other magnet would. So the MagSafe is one thing that I think they should have kept. The second thing that I think they should have kept is the SD card slot. So Apple aims this laptop towards professionals, and a lot of professionals use SD cards for photography, for video, for you name it. SD cards are super popular. And the other port that I think Apple should have kept is 1 or even 2 would have been nice, USB Type-A ports. So these are just the traditional rectangular ports that you can only plug in one way. And they work with pretty much any device that you have. So even if you didn't have an SD card slot on your computer, let's say you're getting your photos or video from a camera, you can at least plug in your camera into your computer via USB Type-A. So if somehow they couldn't fit an SD card slot, I think USB Type-A, 1 or 2, preferably 2 of those ports would have been nice. So on the left side, you still have your traditional MagSafe. Then you also have 2 USB Type-A ports. And then on the right side, keep those 2 USB Type-C ports, because eventually we will have to transition to USB Type-C. You're going to see many other computer manufacturers, even phones that are going to be using USB Type-C. It's going to become the new norm. It might even be like the only port that we use. So keep 2 of those on the right side. And if there's room, add an SD card slot. Now, I'm not like an engineer. I'm definitely not like a technical engineer or anything like that. But if I know Apple, I know that they can do a lot of cool things. They know ways of getting around anything. They're really good engineers, and I think they could have done this. But for now, it looks like people who purchase the MacBook Pro and pretty much any MacBook in the future, you can bet on that from now on, they're going to have to be using dongles in a year or two. We probably won't have that problem. Everything will be connecting via USB Type-C. But for now, it's a hard transition to make. Now, Apple's always been part of the premium computer market. They've always had expensive computers, but the build quality is great. They're super fast. And Apple kind of has an exclusivity because their computers are the only computers that run Mac OS. So it's easy for them to kind of set the price because their computers are so much different. Not really, but they're different in many ways to other Windows computers. Now, even with all the added hardware and all the new updated things, it's an expensive computer. I think if they kept the price of the MacBook Pros the same as the old, exactly the same starting base price, moving up from different processors, different RAM, different solid state drives, if they kept that pricing scheme, I think they would have been fine with this. but they did raise them a considerable amount. And Windows laptops that compete spec-wise with the MacBook Pros, they might not have as great of a build quality or aesthetics, and they're running Windows, so they don't have the exclusivity, but they're still considerably less. So in summary, I think with the specs that the MacBook Pro has, it's going to be a super fast computer. I also think it looks great, and it's really thin and light, especially for the performance that you get inside of it. But when it came to ports, I think Apple innovated a little too much. They're just jumping the gun a little too soon. And for right now, at least for the next year or two, people that buy this laptop are going to be a little bummed out. Anyways, those are my thoughts on the 2016 MacBook Pro. Let me know what your thoughts are in the comments down below. But thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video.